Three people were thrown into Silver Lake in Madison on Saturday when a powerboat collided with their canoe. The driver of that powerboat told Marine Patrol officers he didn't see the canoe until it was too late. Jennifer Gannon joins us now with our top story. Jennifer.
Well, Audrey, the good news is that nobody was seriously injured in the accident, but officials say this could have been a lot worse.
We heard a loud bang, and we thought somebody hit the propeller on their boat.
Nate Underwood and his family live on Silver Lake in Madison and witnessed what happened immediately after a powerboat collided with this canoe.
It looked pretty bad. If it was not an aluminum canoe, it probably would have broken it in half.
Marine Patrol officers say it all started Saturday afternoon when a boat being driven by 54-year-old Scott Audette of Wilmington, Massachusetts, was heading across the lake.
They did throttle up, their bow raised, causing the operator to lose sight of the area in front of him.
Directly in front of him, there was a 17-foot canoe with three people inside.
One of the operators on board that canoe did try to signal that operator stop by screaming, and unfortunately it was a little too late, and that boat did strike that canoe.
All three people on board the canoe were tossed into the water. One woman bruised her leg, but everyone refused medical treatment. Officials say there were life jackets on the canoe, but nobody was wearing one.
Having that life jacket and having it on really makes all the difference.
While everyone on the water should be aware of what's around them, officials say that's especially important if you're in a larger boat.
If you are in a powerboat of any sort, it is your responsibility to make sure that you know what is in front of you and what is around you. It takes just seconds for something like this to happen.
Now, the accident is still under investigation. As of right now, no charges have been filed against the driver of the powerboat. Officials do say that alcohol was not a factor. Reporting live, Jennifer Gannon, WMUR News 9.